Hey guys, Felipe Diva coming to you, and this is the video that I am dreading to make because I know once I make this video, somebody is still not going to get it. And I'm not the best at explaining at tutorials, that's why I don't do too many tutorials. But I'm going to try my best to explain this to you guys. So you asked for it, so I'm going to try to give it to you to show you how exactly I did my closure for my sewing, my full sewing weave, because if you follow my channel, you know I am completely natural, so it's really hard for me to blend my natural hair with, you know, with weave hair textures such as the wet and wavy hair. And I love wet and wavy hair, but I mean sometimes when you're natural it's just not going to work, so you gotta do what you gotta do, right? So with that being said, I actually prefer to have all my hair braided up and no hair shown. I mean, yeah, it's a weave, yeah, you know it's a weave, but so what, it's still pretty, it's still cute, and my hair is being protected, and that's what's most important. I'm rambling, I'm sorry. So I'm trying to avoid it because I know somebody is not going to get it. So it's going to be even harder because I'm going to have to do like in a simulated type of video to show you. So I got some weave hair. This is just, I don't know what this is. I guess some type of deep wavy hair or whatever that I had in my drawer. So, okay. Okay, so let me just say, you remember this is the chocolate hair that I just recently installed. This is day two. And besides being called Diana Ross all day long, I love it. I absolutely love it. I didn't do anything to it this morning. I just stuffed my hair in a bonnet last night and I sprayed my scented water on it this morning and allowed it to air dry, and this is what you get. So okay, I'm rambling still. Alright, let me stop being silly. Let me show you exactly how I did this. Well, try to show you exactly how I did this. Okay, so if you watch the video how I got to this point, I said that I do not cut my tracks at all. I don't cut it at all. Please don't ask me, do I cut my tracks? I do not cut my tracks. I don't cut my tracks. I don't split my tracks. In fact, I don't even put a needle through my tracks. If you've seen my previous installations, I showed that how you take the needle and thread and go around the track. That is another way how you can preserve your weave hair, because once you start putting things through the track, the hair begins to loosen up, and that's how you get a lot of shedding. People write to me all the time. I know I'm rambling still. My hair is shedding. I don't get much shedding when I do my weaves. I mean, even when it's like cheap hair, I don't get much shedding because I never take my needle through my track. I never cut the track. Okay, so with that being said, I don't cut the track. So what I did was, let's just pretend I'm doing the sewing. So I'm sewing, track, flip it over, track, flip it over, track, flip it over. So I get to here, okay? Let me see if I can show you like this way. So once you get to the top part, okay? Now if you remember, see, you may have to go back and watch the video. The way my hair was braided for this particular style, in which most sewings I do, I always have a braid going horizontal this way. Okay, this is vertical, this is horizontal. Okay, try to follow me. So I have two horizontal braids going like this. Thank God I did that. Okay, because the reason for those two horizontal braids is once you get to this part up to the top, I mean, it doesn't really matter where you put it, but it's really depending on how you wear your hair, I guess it does matter. So once you get to the top, let's say the second braid, okay, this is so difficult. So this is your weave hair, right? Okay, let's say you just got to this point right here. You're sewing. Let's do it this way. So you're sewing, right? This hair is going this way. This way. You see how the weave hair is going back? Okay, so remember, we're not cutting the track. So you're taking the track and you're bringing it down to the first braid, which is the very first row, horizontal braid, like so. And boom, it's like this now. You got your bangs, your faux bangs in the front, right? But then you're going to have like this, you know, this part because you got a braid and you got, you know, track, and then you got a track here. But remember, you have one track going. You got one track going back, and you got another track coming down like this, right? So depending on how many times you do that, you can double up how many times you want or whatever. You got the track coming down, the track going back. Okay, you follow me? So let's pretend it's like this. This is the front track. This is the back track. So the tracks are now like this. Basically like a sandwich, like a closure. What you want to do is you want to close that up. Closure. So you just want to take your needle and thread and close those two braids. Close those up. And what it's going to do is it's going to pull your tracks like that, right? So then you have like this sandwich, just like a regular old circle closure or whatever. And then what you can do is you can take your comb or whatever, and you can separate the track, the two tracks, you know, however you want to do it. And it looks, it's kind of like a faux part, but not. I told you it's hard to explain, but if you follow me, basically is once you get to the, once you have the two tracks sewn on, one going down, one going back, you follow me, down, back, take your needle and thread and close it up like so. Okay, that's all it is, you guys. It's really, really simple. I know it sounds crazy, but trust me, I'm pretty much self-taught. Nobody showed me how to do this, and it's much easier if you actually do it than to like sit there and watch somebody else do it. It's much easier to just actually do it yourself. I mean, even if you just do a corn roll, two corn rolls, this is what you do. Do two corn rolls on yourself. Make one going like this and another one going behind it. Take one track of hair and sew it going this way, going backwards. You can cut it if you want. I don't care. This is just for practice. Take another track of hair and sew it going down towards your face. Then take those two tracks and sew them together. Go like this. Does that make any sense? I hope so, because I don't know how else to explain it. And that's kind of like you're bringing the two tracks together and you can't see them anymore, because once you start sewing it, I know it's like you're still gonna see it. No, you're not. You're not gonna see it. Trust me. You trust me. I mean, even if you have like a little bit of your, like, I have no hair out, not even baby hairs. I mean, but eventually my braids are gonna get loose and hair can probably come out. But even if you want to have like a little teeny bit of hair out, you can do that too. But it really isn't necessary, because it's a weave. Who the hell cares? Oh, she got a weave. So what? You ain't got a weave. Doesn't matter. I mean, as long as your hair is braided up, your hair, the tracks are sewn on, and the hair is gorgeous. But that's all it really is. Bring it in two tracks together and voila, closure. No circle. I mean, you can do the circle if you want to. Now, let me just say this. That type of closure really only works well on curly hair. I'm not saying how well, I don't know how well it's going to work on straight hair, because one, I very rarely use straight hair. I've always used some type of texture hair for that reason, because I'm not a fan of the circle closure. But with weaves now, they have closures already done for you. You can buy, I mean, they have in all different types of textures, Remy hair, Indian hair, Yaki hair, whatever. So if, even if you're not like the best at doing closures, you can buy an actual closure and then just sew that mother on and you're okay. But if you want to do the method, all you gotta do is have one track going back, one track going forward, and sew those mothers together and closure. I don't know what else to tell you guys, but of course, if you have any questions, let me know. I will do my best to explain it to you better, but that's as good as it gets, you guys. So I hope this helps, and yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.